Hi everybody, we're going to talk about our experience in transferring hospitals for the care of our daughter who has short bowel syndrome. We've been to three different children's hospitals. Actually, before she was born, we were going to a local hospital in the DC area where we live. We decided to take her to Children's Hospital of Philadelphia for the delivery, and we've been to two other children's hospitals since then. And for us, the transition each time was fairly simple, but there are some questions that you may have if you're thinking about transferring, and some things you may want to know that may be useful for you. So basically, when we decided to go to Children's Hospital of Philadelphia for the delivery, that was just something we decided based on our research. Our daughter was diagnosed with an omphalocele before she was born. Children's Hospital of Philadelphia was the best hospital for dealing with omphaloceles, so we decided to go there, and I think it worked out well. It was a very good hospital. We really loved their staff. The nurses especially did an excellent job and cared very well for our daughter. And their special delivery unit is awesome.
Amazing.
yeah. I recommend anyone deliver there who can. So.
And the fact that the NICU was right there. I mean, you deliver and the NICU is right there that you can walk to and be right next to your kid, basically, you know, right away. So that was a plus. Our local hospital here, wasn't like that. I had to deliver in one hospital, and then they would take my kid to another hospital. And you can just imagine, you know, how hard that would have been. But the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia gave us that accessibility to be in the same place. Myself and my daughter. So that was a great plus.
So before we transferred, we called Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. They go by CHOP, so I'm just going to say CHOP for now. They put us in touch with a coordinator who was very helpful. She, asked questions to find out what was the situation as we understood it with our daughter. And she coordinated time for us, a very convenient time, quickly for us to be able to meet with the medical staff there, the doctors. And we went up and had a consultation with them while my wife was still pregnant. They gave us a lot of good information, made themselves available if we had any follow-up questions. And just helped us out with everything. They were very helpful. They have a very good team at CHOP for coordinating transfers and preparing you for anything that's going to happen. They really have a great team there.
Yeah, that first day, I mean, they did like three different exams, I think. And at the end, we met with the doctors, the surgeon, the OBGYN. And so, yeah. And they gave us, you know, all the information that we were looking for as far as they could tell us, and what our options were, and how were things going to look at after our delivery. So that was really good. And they were, like I said, like my husband said, they were very accessible. Like any emails, any phone calls, they were very quick to answer us back.
Yeah, the surgeon actually gave us her cell phone number, which is completely unheard of at other hospitals. And she answered when we called. So our daughter was there for 5 months. And we decided after 5 months that we wanted to try another hospital. Although CHOP did a great job taking care of her, the doctors, nurses, everybody was excellent. With this condition, it's very unique with each child. And for our daughter, she just wasn't making the progress that we wanted to see. So we did some more research and found Boston's Children's Hospital, which is also another excellent hospital that specializes in short bowel syndrome. So we actually got in touch with one of the doctors at Boston, and he actually was also extremely available. He would call us or text us or email us the same day if we had any questions. It was amazing. His response time was usually in less than an hour. And so talking to him for a little while, he answered a lot of our questions, and with a few reservations, we decided to take a chance and go to Boston.
It was one of our hardest decisions that we had to make, because we were we were happy with CHOP, but we were also afraid how much Boston could help us, and you know, because her condition was so rare. So
what we did is the doctor put us in touch with one of the nurses there, physician's assistants, and she answered some additional questions that I had later for follow up, and helped to coordinate the transfer. She made sure that they got the medical records from our daughter, from the hospital that we were at CHOP, and basically took care of everything that they needed to make that happen. I did call our insurance company, and I would recommend before you transfer hospitals, you call your insurance company and make sure that they understand what your plans are, because you want to make sure that your insurance company will cover any changes. Make sure the doctors are in network if they need to be in network or whatever. You just want to make sure that you're going to get the same coverage that you expect to get when you transfer. Your insurance company also many times will have I forget what they call it. A case manager, a nurse who works for the insurance company to make sure that your transfer goes smoothly and that all your needs are taken care of. It's actually in the benefit of the insurance company to make sure that things go smoothly for you, because if there are problems that may result in complications, you know, greater complications to your child, then that could increase costs for the insurance company. So they're actually on your side, and although we didn't use them much, we didn't have much need for them, it's just good for you to know that they are available. Those nurses also can answer questions that you have, and they're supposed to be your advocate with the insurance company. But the hospitals that we dealt with did an excellent job of helping with the transfer. So, this case, when we transferred to Boston, however, our daughter needed medical transport because she wasn't in a condition that she was stable enough for us to take her on our own. So we did need to make sure that the insurance company was going to cover the cost of the medical transport, which they did, fortunately. She had a private medical jet, that was...
It was an ambulance and then a jet.
Yeah, it was a medical transport jet. Mm-hmm. So they had nurses on available that took care of her during the transport from CHOP to Boston. So... and that was it. We flew her over. Only my wife was able to board the plane with our daughter. My son and I had to drive from CHOP up to Boston. We could have flown if we wanted to pay it out of pocket, but we decided to drive. Insurance company would only pay, they would only allow my wife to go with the daughter.
One of the parents.
One parent.
Yeah.
So anyways, we went to Boston, and they also had an excellent staff, great doctors. Nurses did a very good job, and we were there for
8 months,
several more months, and after a while, we also were not seeing the progress that we wanted to see with our daughter. So we did some more searching around and found a doctor that we felt comfortable with here in the DC area, and eventually made the decision to transfer our daughter to National Children's Hospital in Washington, D.C. So again, I called our insurance company. They provided another case manager. They didn't have any issues with us changing hospitals. The costs, the benefits would be the same. And there was not a need this time for medical transport because my daughter was in a stable condition at this point. We were able to drive her home with us and take her to DC Children's Hospital. In fact, by the time we decided to make this transfer, she was already an outpatient at Boston, whereas at CHOP, she was inpatient the entire time. So, yeah, that was it. Insurance approved everything, and medical transport was not needed. And we were already living here in this area. We just decided to stop taking her to Boston, and we started going to D.C.
And our doctor in Boston understood, you know, why we were doing this, and he completely encouraged us to follow our whatever we, you know, thought it was best for our daughter. I mean, since things were not really working out as we wanted it. So, and also the first time that we transferred, the first time that we did it from CHOP to Boston, it was a little bit hard, you know, for us because we were at CHOP for 5 months. We built a relationship with our doctors, our surgeon, our GI doctor, you know, and all of a sudden to tell them, oh, we're moving, we're taking our daughter to another hospital, you know. It was a little bit, for me at least, weird, awkward, because I didn't want to offend them. I didn't want them to think that I wasn't happy or I, you know, but I was more looking for the well-being of my daughter. So that day that we sat with them, it was a little bit hard, you know, and they also were attached to my daughter. So, yeah. But at the end of the day, they understood. They helped us to do the transfer, you know, do all the paperwork needed and everything else. So. Yeah.
One other thing, some hospitals are better than others for the transfer of patients, and basically the only thing that's needed is for them to receive the medical records of your child. Some offices are better at that than others, so you may want to do some follow-up if you're transferring. Make sure that the receiving hospital gets the paperwork that they need and that the hospital that you're leaving was able to send it, and you know, you may need to make calls or show up in person at one location or the other to make sure that everybody's doing what needs to be done. You may need to obtain the records on your own and transfer them yourself to make sure that they make it there.
That's what we did too.
But anyways, at all three hospitals that we've been to so far, all three of the children's hospitals, they've all provided excellent service, excellent care. But you know, they've all had different approaches to how they provided that care. And with short bowel syndrome, as I said before, each child is very unique, and the way that they respond to different treatments is very unique. So you can go to an excellent hospital, and the treatment they provide there may not be what works best for your child. In our case, we've been to three of the best hospitals in the country, and the one that we're at now is where we have so far seen the best progress for our daughter. Which is not to say necessarily that the other hospitals didn't do a wonderful job, because they all did. But the treatment that our daughter's receiving now is what seems to be working best for her. We've seen, you know, we saw at the other hospitals children that received the same treatment that our daughter was getting. Some of the other kids
thriving.
Prospered much better than ours did, receiving the same treatment. So it just depends on each child. I just want to emphasize that all of the hospitals that we've been to have been excellent hospitals. And it's worth looking around if your child has a complicated condition, it's worth looking around, getting a second opinion.
Or a third opinion, like in our case.
Seeing what works best.
Yeah.
And for us, where we are right now is what's working best for our daughter. Mm-hmm. So we intend to stay here, at least for now, and as long as she keeps making progress.
Right, as long as she's doing good, yeah.
We're happy.
We're happy. So, but yeah, we were... it was a task, you know, to call around to, you know, with insurance, with the doctor, talk to the doctors and everything else. But it can be done. So don't be afraid. Don't feel like you can't do it. Always speak up and talk to other parents too. That also help us to make some decisions along the run. Yeah, don't just settle for whatever you have. I mean, if you feel like you could get a better treatment or, you know, you're stuck, always look for a second, third opinion. It's worth it. It's your child. So this is our experience. Hopefully it helps you. If you have any questions, you can leave it down in the comments below. And if you want us to talk about any other topic, let us know too. We would love to share our experiences with you to help you, because we know how hard this road can be. So anyway, wishing you all the best. Take care. Bye.
Bye.